I don't see it.
We live? Woo! All right, but there's on delay, so let me wait till we show up.
Welcome. Matt, introduce the beautiful situation that we have here.
Yes, we are live. Welcome back to 997, not a podcast, not a radio show, powered by Amuse.io. This is season 6, episode 6, with the normal, not really the normal squad around the table, and not really a table. We are not, you know, we're all at home doing what we can. We got Rashad the Dot Wave God.
What up?
Rashad, please introduce yourself.
What's good? I'm here on the virtual tip at the crib. I'm in Jersey right now. Ready to do it. Let's do it. Twitch style.
Streamed in live. We don't have Genesis here. She had further engagements that she had to take care of. We wish her the best. We've got Mike Rocks, our IT and 997 artistic director, as you may know. And Mike's own coworker, a very special guest on the stream today, the publishing A&R at Secretly Group, Melanie McClain. Melanie, welcome to the new virtual Not 97.
Thank you.
You want to tell people a little bit about who you are, what you do, and where you come from?
Yeah, I'm Melanie, born and raised in Chicago, based in Brooklyn. I'm currently a publishing A&R at Secretly Group. And we have the home of Moses Sumney, Jamila Woods, I Know More Orchestra, Angel Olsen, and so many amazing artists. Prior to joining Secretly last year, I was a hip hop content music specialist, which is a fancy way of saying I did hip hop playlist programming at YouTube Music. I was a staff writer at Salon de Saint Haran, artist manager, and so many things under the sun. But number one, I'm a music lover.
Perfect. We're happy to have you.
Thank you.
Wishing it were under better circumstances, but we appreciate you coming on to, you know, test the Not 97, not a live stream for the first time. But yeah, we're going to start it off just as we always do. I'm going to introduce the first song by an artist from Northwest London. Her name is Chloe Bodur. This song was released 12 days ago. She's been making music for a couple years, since around 2017, I think she dropped her debut single. She studied music. She may have graduated at a university, at a music university in London. So kind of a music school alumni, and has a really interesting kind of modern jazz soul vibe, very much like that kind of kind of rich jazz singer that we hear a lot in London, I think, these days from these young artists, which is a scene that I've definitely been tapped into and found a lot of artists that I really fuck with. This song, topically enough, is called Lovely Lonely. And yeah, I'm excited to get into it. Mike, hit it. Lovely Lonely by Chloe Bodur.
We on air 100% of the time. Huh?
Yeah, but when he's like playing the song, you can't hear us.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Can you hear the song? Hey.
Not yet. Damn, but we can't hear the song, huh?
Oh, but we can't hear the song, true. So we gotta make it live or something. Melanie, I'll send you all the songs if we can hear it.
I got pulled up on my phone right now. Because of wild nights, the thoughts that guard my dreams, my lonely blues, the color I used to paint the sky that I picture through. If the phone never rings, could end up boiling silver by a dirty kitchen sink. Ma won't like the pictures of syringes that I'm painting. Illusions of her holding my body cold, shaking.
Alright, unmute your mic. We are back. Everybody unmute their microphone. There we go. A little technical difficulty at the beginning where people heard us over the song, but you know, we're just getting used to this. But yeah, that's Lovely Lonely by Chloe Bodur, Northwest London. Read a couple interviews with her. She said that music is definitely kind of a healing thing for her. And she writes music as kind of a way to get her energy and her feelings out and kind of heal with everything that goes on in the world. But yeah, everything there from kind of her delivery and the feel of the song to the guitar and those drums just kind of hit me, and I got wrapped up in it and really wanted to share it.
Yeah, I didn't catch everything, but what I caught was fire. Her vocal sound is smooth. And I'm gonna have to run it back later on so I can get the full experience. But I feel like it was, from what I heard, it's hitting the vibe of right now, the calming, the tones that we need to relax in the crib. So I appreciate that.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, definitely add to people's quarantine playlist. Like, it's what are those
ASAP
things like okay, like the name, the tone, like, okay, like, I've been in my house for 3 weeks. This is what I'm going to listen to. Like,
yeah. Yeah, we made a 997 cleaning playlist that we got to share with everybody, because all these songs this season, we've been playing them and people are like, I would clean to this, but we really need to get up on our quarantine playlist tip, because it's what we're all doing right now.
Yeah, I think this, the quarantine took the cleaning playlist to another level. It just developed, it's morphed into a whole new being.
Now it's like the disinfectant playlist. It's like, what do you listen to while you disinfect everything in your house and yourself?
But yeah,
it smells like bleach. What does your playlist sound like? Yeah.
Yeah. Lovely, I mean, Lonely by Chloe Bodur. Definitely on.
You know, it's definitely still on top of like the trend of what's going on in the past couple of years too, with just the neo soul thing coming back in and then just really taking over. So I think it's gonna have a lot of success on our playlist in general over the next few months.
Yeah, I mean, I think it is interesting to see that like everything within like the jazz soul R&B mood coming out of the UK and how it is like a very rich scene right here. I mean we've played a ton of artists that fit into that category, all from the same city, and so I think everybody has kind of their own different angle to it from what they grew up listening to or what they grew up playing and what their influences are. But it's such a rich sound, like that mood is to me like never gonna get old. I'm never gonna get bored of listening to music like that.
That's what they say. That's grown folks music. When you were a kid, you know what I'm saying? It's that timeless, timeless shit that you don't understand until you know deeper in your 20s.
Yeah, and I'm kind of obsessed with like the kind of UK like jazz resurgence. I can't think of his name right now, but I went to a show last year and he had like someone from De La Soul featured on the track. And it's just like a cool movement that I see growing that I'm so excited about.
Yeah.
Tom Misch. I saw Tom Misch. Yeah, like Tom Misch is like kinda in that wave and there's a lot of other people. I'm waiting for it to like that was a show at Terminal 5, but I'm really to see it's like his apex. I'm ready for that.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I agree. All right. Melanie, you wanna take it? All right. Oh, what are you gonna say?
No, sorry. I was gonna say, you know, always shout out London one last time before we switch over because we love it here.
Nah, shout out London for real. We got to tap in with the London family, do a little showcase out, you know.
Really post-corona. Fun.
Yeah, post-corona, catch us in London. For real. All right, Melanie, you want to take us into Sensitive?
Yeah, next up is Sensitive by Serena Isioma and Chicago Artist 19. I'll talk more after we play, but I'm excited about this.
All right, so this is.
I like the intro.
That's the Rashad intro. Keep it short and sweet. This is Sensitive by Serena Isioma. Serena Isioma. Time to mute mics. Gotta get money by any means. I'm switching up on my boss, I'm getting mean. She wanna be with a boss with loyalty. I laid it down on my BDG ripped jeans. I laid it now, she's addicted, a fucking fiend. She got around, now she fucking the whole squad. That pussy looking like the sign of the cross on God. Leaning to the side, it's spilling water. Smash, then pass. Fuck, niggas always tryna take my shit. How you gon' feel when I go take it, yo, bitch? Nigga, I don't mean it, yo, chick. Bitches these days are so sensitive. Niggas always tryna take my shit. How you gon' feel when I don't take it, yo, bitch? Nigga, I don't mean it, yo, chick. Bitches these days are so sensitive. I'd never sell out for a check, you stupid motherfucker. I'll buy a house and on my own I'll put that on my mother. My babes gon' rock Christian Dior. I'll put that on my lover. We back?
Yeah, so I'm really excited about that song, especially just because she represents like this new generation of like cross-generational young Black artists, like the ones who were raised off of like Tyler and like all that type of stuff. And the fact like she like plays guitar and she plays the drums and like her music is listed as pop on like Apple Music, like, and like, you know, she's releasing like her music through like Fashionably Early, like one of the biggest tastemaker blogs right now. So and she just represents like what music should be for this current generation. I love it.
Yeah, I was gonna ask, I saw that on SoundCloud it said released by Fashionably Early, so they're like, is that like a label that they have that they're releasing her music through?
I know, like I'm like cool with Kyle there, and they just put out a few releases. And I mean, I'm glad about it because I feel like I got my start in music by like pitching stuff to Pigeon Planes, and they broke a lot of things and like broke artists that I worked with. So I feel like it's needed. Like, you look at, you know, Billie Eilish, and like she was first posted by Hilly Dilly. Imagine if, like, she put out a couple tracks by Hilly Dilly 4 years ago. Like, you know, I feel like blogs should be part of the story a little bit longer, and besides just like, oh, we posted about them when they first were coming up when they were unsigned. So I love it.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, I think that's for a lot of you know, blogs and people that are curating music, that's the next level, being able to work with those artists directly to put the music out. I mean, that song's fire, like from the jump. Like, and I heard the lyrics are on SoundCloud, they're probably elsewhere on the internet, but I would recommend everybody go to her SoundCloud and read those lyrics, because like right away the energy is like, is huge. It's all over. And then one with the beat hits and those synths come in, like that record is super hard.
Yeah, and then you got the switch up, you know, obviously the big shout out. I kind of like the live element where the crowd gets the comment, and I see a couple people shouting out the switch up, which is always fresh. And like highlighting everything, just piggybacking on what you guys said, just young Black artists being able to be creative and experiment with different sounds, which, you know, it wasn't really a thing not too long ago. So it's great to see like everybody being able to jump in on that and really build on how people like Tyler started waves in that arena.
Yeah.
And then, and one last thing, like, as someone from Chicago, like, I'm excited about like this like new Chicago movement. It's like she's killing it. Like Nambi, whose album comes out Friday, streamed by Brat on Friday on Super Records. But like, it's like a new school of like Chicago that I feel like it's like Chicago had the cool kids and it has like Chance, but I feel like the new wave of it's like really just kind of like bursting all the boxes. And like, yes, it's hip hop, yes, it's vocals, it's this, but like, it's everything, and then it's like not a lot too. It's like, it's the best thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Chicago definitely has built a unique yet ambiguous sound. It's like you can't really box it into things, but it's like purposely different, I guess. Which is great.
That's a dope one. Purposefully different. But yeah, I mean, and every Chicago artist, I feel like, is just super dynamic, super multidimensional. And after I listened to this song, I listened to it a couple of times and I had to go back and look how long it was, because it felt like you get so wrapped up in it that there's so much in there, and it's only like a 3-minute song. But with the switch up and everything, there's so much of her, so much energy that like comes through there, that is really like, it gets stuck in your head. It's definitely like a contagious track that you want to just kind of keep playing over and over, always go back to it.
Yeah, and check out her project. She just put out a project that's like only 5 tracks that we were just talking about, that has like the sound, and then some things are just more laid back, but like it shows the diversity of like who she is and like what she's going to do in the future. So definitely keep that up.
Yeah, I like that. All right, Rashad, what you got for us?
Oh, I'm up next. Of course I am. All right, here we go. We're just going to do Knucks Home.
The victim, whose name currently cannot be disclosed, is now among over 51 young people who have been fatally stabbed in London this year alone. Last month, more than 250
made in a manner. I take off my D-square top that I rock and I place on a hanger. Just touch home from the motive, text get home safely to Anna. I see man I got plenty to say when I'm out, but they never ever say it when they gang up. Can't take man for a spanner, next time man I'm taking a dagger. Now I'm staring at my open door, marginal hallway balling, talk about how I'm getting home by 4. Big man at 17, can't be stuck up my home no more. Mom saying stuff about opening up, but that's what the bros are for. Man, I got wholesome days and wanna be alone some days. True say, I be at home some days and drilling with the bro some days. We was on the field and the no-go ends when you're chilling with your mom at home. Free man up in the four-door bends when you're chilling with your mom at home. Can't you see London's burning and you can't duck this smoke? Man, know about serving, man, know about the pot and stove. Feel like I've been on the road most days, where true say I never been home. Mom told me come home some days, but true say I never did go. Wait, true say I never did. Anna, this chick that I text from college. Steady tryna learn about man, but I'm just tryna get this knowledge. Always chasing these worthless guys, I bet you the man ain't on it. I bet if gang put it on them, I bet the man run like Forrest. WhatsApp call from a guy, said he got a vibe tonight. Then he put up around 9, text call, you see me blood, I'm outside. Quickly jump in my Knucks, hardly need to change clothes. Walk out the door to see mumsy nagging, asking me to stay home. No, man, I got wholesome days and wanna be alone some days. True say, I be at home some days and drilling with the bro some days. We was on the field and the no-go ends while you're chilling with your mom at home. Free man up in the four-door bends while you're chilling with your mom at home. Can't you see London's burning and you can't duck this smoke? Man, know about serving, man, know about the pot and stove. Feel like I've been on the road most days, where true say I never been home. Mom told me come home some days, but true say I never did go. Wait, true say I never did 30. Touched at 11:30. When I stopped at my bridging's yard, went trying to get there too early. My bridging said when I drink this hard, in a minor issue will stir me. Then I turn my head and see Anna with some guy that's moving too thirsty. Like, where did they find this Donny? Ladies, man, yeah, think man's funny. Call me getting rap, call me take man's money. Matter of fact, man's gonna confront him. Walked up, pushed him and said, what's good? Looked at me confused and he said nothing. She was like, babes, wait, stop it. Weren't gonna ching, man, I was just bluffing. But I can't just stand there discussing. At least not in front of Anna. Gotta come badder. Matter of fact, where's my dagger? What did it drop in the car from my pocket? No way, no way, my doggy has got it. Then out of the blue, when I put it in his right hand, then he did my man right in the stomach. Shit. Now they got man running. All my life I taste vomit. 10 toes to the bends, man, I ended up throwing up on the bonnet. Now I hear sirens while we tryna zing up the road. Then I look down, I see bare missed calls. That's mumsy ringing my phone. I should've went home. Man, I got wholesome days, I wanna be alone some days. True say, I be at home some days and drilling with the bro some days. We was on the field and the no-go ends while you're chilling with your mom at home. Free man up in the four-door bends while you're chilling with your mom at home. Can't you see London's burning and you can't duck this smoke? Man, know about serving, man, know about the pot and stove. Feel like I've been on the road most days, where true say I never been home. Mom told me come home some days, but true say I never did go. Wait, true say I never did.
An update has just come in on the incident. The police have apprehended three suspects caught speeding in a black Mercedes a couple of miles from the stabbing. Let's go over to our correspondent who is currently live at the scene.
Man, I got wholesome days and wanna be alone some days.
Hey,
yeah, we back. So, you know me, I had to tap in the UK real quick one time.
Yeah, Knucks, you see, my dude Shane said top boy.
Yeah, facts, top boy. It's the 100% should be on the next top boy soundtrack. You know, my boy is from London, of course. And I just felt some type of way, man. I had to play it, and he's a real storyteller. What really drew me to this in particular track, like I watched the video. The video is, he's not as big, but the video has like a million views because the video itself, it's like a whole story, and like, it goes along with the lyrics, and it really illustrates the whole shit very well. And so I came across the video a while ago, and then I was like, man, I'm not gonna play it because, you know, I just feel like it's kind of too popular. And then I was like, no, fuck it. This is the perfect shit for today. Everybody's at home. The video is sick. We're gonna be on live. So I would have shared my screen, but I'm not that nice. So I feel like everybody, he got some other hits too. He's just a really fucking good storyteller. Like, a lot of his stories kind of play out the same way, but then there's not like this overbearing ass, like, I don't feel like he's rapping at me at the same time. Like, there's still smooth jazz type of shit going on. And I'm just a big fan of UK rap, so I'm always gonna put on when I can. He's like, he's a young kid, 24 years old. So yeah, man, that's what I brought to the table first time around.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, Melanie, what'd you think?
No, I liked it. It was like midpoint, this kind of like, I don't like this jazzy little part that kind of wasn't even a transition, but kind of a little like a layer added to a little paprika, if you will, you know, like, like that was nice. Like, I mean, like, I've been listening to like UK rap since like literally school. Like, I have embarrassing stories of like liking 10 member like British boy band. So like, like I'm this is up my alley. Like, you know, like every iteration of like what's happening, I love, and this is like cool. Like, I'm definitely gonna look up more stuff that he's been up to. Yeah, new fan for sure.
Knucks, yeah. Definitely, definitely a big move. And I love that. It took me a few listens to be like, oh shit, this is like Rashad's quarantine song. Cause it's like, I'll be home some days. I want to be alone some days.
Yo, that's what I'm saying. I had to pull it out. The lyrics are too perfect. I'm like, this sounds exactly like what the people need to hear. Like, shit, I want to be alone some days. I want to be with the bros some days, damn it. But I'm at home.
Like, it takes on a whole new meaning now.
For real, for real. A million views later, this shit has a whole nother context. But I think he's clearly got some shit going for him. And you know, he's also performed a little bit around. Like, he's gonna be around for a while. You should be on the lookout for shit he's coming out with for sure.
Yeah, I bet he's like definitely next up in the UK scene. Also, I mean, you know me, anytime there's like a little piano or little horns on a hip hop track, I'm a sucker.
Yeah. He also did, not to forget, a live session of this song with like a live saxophone and like a whole shit. It's also on his YouTube channel, which is fresh, which makes actually the closing factor that made me pick the song. Cause I saw the song already, and he recently uploaded like the acoustic version with the live band and shit. And I was like, all right, this guy, he's like on some shit. He trying to make this shit go up for real. And the video, since I saw it, had like, it didn't have a million views at the time. So I'm like, okay, I might as well play it now before I seem like it's too late. Cause he still has only like 15,000 followers, and like his SoundCloud is even lower. It has like maybe 11,000 or something like that. But yeah, definitely, definitely keep an eye out.
Yeah. Big mood.
Big Home mood team.
Knux. Big rock, team. Rock. All right. I'm gonna switch it back to the US. My next pick is this dude named Angelo Leroi, from California. I believe he lives in Boston right now and goes to Berklee College of Music. I didn't even realize it at first, but now that I'm thinking about it, both my artist Ramley are like music school graduates. But this is one of those dudes that I was just kind of like deep in SoundCloud yesterday trying to figure out what I wanted to introduce today. And sometimes I go around SoundCloud and find what I want to listen to pretty quickly. And sometimes it takes me down a rabbit hole and I feel like I have to dig super deep to find that one thing that like screams at me. And that's definitely what this was. This was like deep down there that I had to go through a bunch of different accounts to down these little rabbit holes and find Angelo Leroi and tap into his music. This This song came out on an EP released a little bit ago called TV Dinner. But this band has been making really kind of interesting music for at least 3-4 years now. So yeah, I want to get into it, and then we can kind of talk about what he's doing afterwards. This song is called Sanford and Sons by Angelo Leroi.
I don't know what to do anymore.
It's scary seeing the man I'm growing up to be. When people speak my name, I hope I'm never in your company.
Taking things that are unfortunate and putting a spin on it. If you're gonna engage, then engage 100%. It can't be a ruse. Whether you communicate that directly or that's just in your vibe, they know it somehow.
Nice. That tone.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that, like, he's not in the industry or, like, anything. Angelo Leroi, like, he's definitely kind of a young, undiscovered kid making music for himself and whoever will listen. But I was, like, yeah, I was deep in SoundCloud, found TV Dinner, the EP. Kind of dove into this, and there's so much kind of like so much like soul, and I don't know, it sounds like history in his voice.
Hey, you ain't lying. That's I love the title. Number off top, I don't think it got included before the song came on. Sanford and Son, top five titles in the history of 997. And
wait, what does that title mean to you?
It's one of the well, first of all, my dad likes Sanford and Son a lot, as well as my grandpa, so I fuck with it. And it's also like the story of a black family with like a junkyard, and not a junkyard, that's yeah, with like a junkyard and like a whole bunch of shit going on. And it's a very historic black show, so I guess if it sounds like history, it makes sense, I guess. It's like a historic black sitcom is named after. And then this overall, you know, it sounds like grown folks music, like I was saying before. So you got two grown folks music picks. I don't know what you've been on, Matt. You've been growing up.
This quarantine really, like, really, I'm getting.
Yeah, man, you getting tapped in.
Personal growth season. No.
But no. I love that.
Yeah, like, vocals are almost like, might be like Brittany Howard or someone like that. It was like this, like, rootsy, you know, like that soulful, but in like kind of like, I don't know, I the word is like rootsy that I really don't feel like I hear a lot in a lot of music. It's, yeah, really cool.
Yeah.
It's like an earth tone almost. Like, you know, it's rootsy is like the thing that's just like, it feels grassroots, feels like so organic. I don't know how to explain it. And I think that's the best thing when it comes to a R&B singer's voice. If it's almost unexplainable, you're like, okay, this is a unique voice. You know, like you can't really recreate it, which is the most important thing when you're trying to break out, I think, as an R&B singer, is a distinctive voice.
Yeah, no, definitely. And especially because the first voice on that song, at first I listened to it and to me, I thought it sounded sort of like a female voice. And I was trying to see if there's like a female vocalist that's featured on it, and I couldn't. And then the more I listened to it, I was like, oh shit, no, that's his voice. It's just like either pitched up a little bit or he's just like hitting that note and then almost mellowing it out later on in that chord, which, I mean, that part just kind of like blew my mind.
No, I love that stuff. Like I was like I'm a fan of Rye, and it's like a whole bunch of other people that like, when they start, they almost are mysterious just because it's kind of like, okay, you're gonna like the music and you don't know what my identity is, like you just know like this like falsetto is insane, and it's not even like, oh my god, this person's great because like they're male and they have this, it's like, no, this song's good. And I love like music that's just like, it's not even about a gimmick, it's just like you love it. And like, this is cool, like this is definitely cool.
Yeah, I tapped into, he's got some, like if you go to his Instagram, he's got some like recent live sessions that look like in the homie's living room, like him doing a show, or like in really tight basement venues and stuff like that. And he's got a lot of energy, like he's got a little band with him and he's really like going for it, which I fuck with. That to me, like, that's the most exciting time for some of these young artists, when they're really just kind of like coming into their own as like a performer, and who they are and how they represent themselves through their music.
Which honestly could probably say is understated in the development of artists nowadays, performing, which is probably a good time to give some developmental tips to what you could be doing during Corona, you know, doing shit like that, you know, working on your performing and just locking in. So I know, Matt, you are a sucker for that, though. You are a sucker for the live performance.
Yeah, he also... Oh, no, go ahead.
Oh, just a piggyback, like, kind of, like, talking about voices, like Baby Rose is an example of someone who has that. Kind of, like, wish that most people kind of have, like, you know, it's, like, some songs, okay, you sound, have a nice voice, and someone else can sing it, but when you have, like, that tone, like, you can do a cover of anything, and it's going to take it to, like, a whole different, like, universe. So I kind of wish, like, he could, like, do maybe, like, some covers or something like that, or, like, repurpose some songs right now, because it's going to be completely different than it. Or like some songs that like are soulful, but they're not soul songs, you know? And like, okay, yeah, you're gonna do a cover of that like Dirty Projector song, or like you're gonna do a cover of that, like, you know, the kind of like, this is not R&B, but it touches me in a special way. Like, it would be cool if like he did a cover of those types of songs. And add, yeah, like, okay, let me take this to another, this is the way you wish to sound it. If like this person did it on American Idol, like, yeah.
Yeah. That's, you know, shout out to Moses Sumney doing the Ariana Grande song.
Yeah.
Yeah, that just shows, I guess it shows like the artist range, if you know, like just their vocal range in general. Like, let's just pick a song that it has soul, but may not be a soul song, just to like show my character, my voice, and like what I can do.
Yeah.
And then all of, we have those guilty pleasures, and it's kind of like, I mean, I love Ariana. I've been to like 3 Ariana Grande Stadium tours, not ashamed of it. But time, like the people who are like, like, to like X, Y, and Z. I think it's like that way we covers of like, okay, you really like this song. If a pop person didn't make it, like, less appreciated in this, like, and I think it's important to have those moments too.
Totally. Yeah. Now, my last thing about Angelo. Well, so Angelo, check him out. I went to his Twitter and 2 days ago, he tweeted, "Took me 4 years to get my drums sitting like I really want them." And I just really fuck with them. Like, my dude's been, you know, that shows a lot. He's been, for 4 years, he's been producing his own shit. And it shows, like, you know, your drums are hitting my.
Let him know his hard work has paid off, man.
Yeah, facts.
There you go. What we got next?
Melanie, you're next. Tell us about Rektless.
Yeah, so I went to Chicago before. No, I got to do my. This is a cool artist, Mwami, based here, originally from Uganda. And like the colors, like not the videos, but like the kind of blog website they have, I came across him there. And just a cool artist, doing electronic artist, but has like vocals on it that's kind of in that Channel Trace lane. And I want to see more people do this just because, like, as a love of hip hop, but also love electronic and love R&B and pop is like, once again, I love hearing these cross genre sounds. So check out Rektless. Great, great release, great song.
Cool. This is Rektless by Mwami.
It's that dance floor gospel. Soundtrack to the downward spiral. Squad deep in that D-Rail mode. Same G's in that mean lot movie. Strut like the Mean Girls montage. Believe we look cute, you. Better dance to these tunes, cause ain't no bougie bitches in the rave. Better be grateful we came. Pull up in the steeds you can't chew. Flex off the bad mood like, ooh, look what you made me do. Look what you done made me do. They ain't ready for me. She Bogo kid, be on your ass. No chip, be long hand. I keep the backup plan, yeah. Passing to my fuck you and my index. Silent in the foyer for a quick. The body needs heaven, reminiscing and working, pulling up to the furnace and had to rally. Keep the body is spin, fresh to death, since it blinks. If I light a candle for a path, but you ran while I roll up to the branches, Andres, at the electrons with the ashes. Beside niggas on the guest list. Sublime with the shit, but you slept on us, slept on it, I'm passive. Keep dreaming passive. Black stains on a white tee, like the accent. Couldn't get the ends if I told you where we started. Audubon wound when I was throwing some hookah bar. Bullet with the homies, so shake. Living, making mistakes by the day. On a pile up, on a night loops. On a daily like it's light work. Ruminate the right moves till the night sky be light, like and violet. Time on whip back is tiring. Twilight whiplash is violent. Motherfucker, I need silence. School sus, trap two up in hydrate. IJ rock, maneuver, shift sideways. On highways, on high grade with goons.
Kawaii, bitch, this boo.
Play, meet the dance floor gospel. Soundtrack to the downward spiral. Squad deep in the deep end mode. Same G's in the main live movie. Come short like the Mean Girls montage. Cold beef with the new week, go yard. Dark summer, keep the heaters on solar. Zip lines from the trees, let my vices menage. Oh God, oh God.
Yeah. Hard. I'm trying to hear that as soon as I get out of lockdown. I'm trying, first song, trying to hear that. in a loud space, in a big loud space.
I've been lucky to hear it live once, and I can't lie, it's fire. Like I don't know if the crowd even knew it, and they just started all like gathering and dancing. Like, you know, it's like music for dance floors is amazing. Like, yeah.
Yeah. Everybody is saying in the comments that they wanted it to be live, which I think is a testament to that one, which, you know, we want to hear more. But I think it is interesting because I could see a DJ spinning that in the club and drawing it out for super and like having the drops here and there and kind of, you know, goading you that it's going to go in here and really letting the groove sit in.
Oh yeah, for sure. I could definitely see. It's like a DJ paradise, you know. It's a lot of different ways to get in and out of that song if you're mixing, and just overall the energy of the song is obviously built for a function, for a party. Like, people are gonna want to dance as soon as they hear it. Everybody that did comment, they want to hear more because they, you know, we track. You gotta get that energy out.
And and the crazy thing about it, it came on this Protein EP, and like literally there's like three versions of the song. It's like another version of it, like that sounds like almost completely different. There's like a club edit of it. So like literally it's like dance music that's like made for the streaming era, but also like literally made for the club. And it's like, okay, like in one setting you have this one, another setting all this song. So I love it, like songs that are fun but also very intentional too.
Yeah, true. True. I mean, also, wow. Like, it's cool the way the whole song builds, too, because it starts somewhat minimal in terms, like, the beat is somewhat minimal at the beginning, which is, like, it's like you feel the energy revving up, and then by the end, it's, like, wild dynamic with sounds coming in from, like, all different angles. Like, I was listening to the K-Tronata album earlier, and once I got into the groove of this, I was, like, yeah, it's just feel good dance music, but you can listen to it in any context.
Yeah, I love it. I like this a lot. I hope somebody played this in a club soon.
Yeah.
Very
where'd you say?
And a cool thing with Annie is like he's like originally from Uganda, and I feel like when we think about dance music, we have to like I love like UK dance music. I love what's happening. Germany, of course, like Chicago, Detroit, but also like I think we gotta realize like dance music is like something that's really an international thing, and like I love what's happening in South Africa right now. You know, it's like it's so many different regions, and I think it's like we gotta push ourselves and not just like look in the same places for great dance music because like there's some heat out here.
Yeah, facts.
Yeah, I think this is definitely like inherently a world sound. Like you definitely hear that world sound immediately. So just to piggyback on that, and I feel like the world sound or the Afrobeat and everything is all has a space to take over the clubs, and it is taking over the clubs internationally. But like even here domestically in the U.S., like it's gonna come even harder. Probably if we were going outside this summer, probably even more this summer. But last summer it was Afrobeat was a very very big thing, and it probably would only have gotten bigger now. So I'm excited to see what the world sound coming from Africa can translate to in the U.S.
No, I agree. Like West Africa is like has like, you know, the Afrobeat, the Afropop movement. Like East Africa has their cool thing going on. Like South Africa has Koedo. Like it's like, you know, I think it's that time that we really really like I'm mad that I didn't go to Ghana in December. Like hopefully everything will be fine so I can go to Ghana this December. But you know, it's like I'm really like there's like an Alte scene going on right now. Like when I worked at YouTube, I did a lot of Afrobeats playlisting. It's like it's so many cool niches like that we're discovering like that are happening. Like so I'm excited. I'm so excited.
Yeah. And we're really catching up. It's also because we incorporated like a lot of the UK where we're recognizing the UK music scene, which has been incorporating like the African music. So it's like now we're kind of just as the US population being like, oh, there's other music in the world.
Yeah, like the but Afro swing, yeah. And like having like someone like Dave's like has like a huge hit with like Burna Boy. You know, it's just like you know, like AJ Tracy, like it's like tons and tons of people like in the UK, like this is old news. Like UK funky is one of my favorite music genres. It's like, oh, good job, America. We knew we acknowledged our history a long time ago. Like
about time 2020, we made it. But facts.
Does he still like live in Uganda?
Oh no, he's in Brooklyn.
Oh word.
But like that's the cool thing. And like the thing about him is like his co-producers are literally from around the world. Like some of his co-producers never even met. And I think that's kind of like the new generation of artists too. Like the quarantine is a hard time, but like this song came out like at the 8 month mark, but I think it represents how artists really can use this time to like share files. And like I work in publishing. So a big thing is about like doing sessions and working together. But also like if you find someone to connect with, like don't have the mentality of like, hey, let's build when like we're outside. Like if you can, like hit their DMs up, like send some files now. Like it doesn't matter, like the song might come out when we're all outside, but like at least like think about creating these songs now. Don't just think of always like let me do it after, because it's kids in Brooklyn, it's kids in different parts of the world who are like making amazing songs like just for their like computers and their bedroom.
Yeah, 100%.
And I think a lot of people who are internet rappers or whatever you want to call it, like they have been doing that a lot of times. Like, and I think for musicians, it shouldn't stop your drive, because a lot of people do try to reach out to whoever it may be as they're creating it. I know a lot of people, especially producers, who are sending, you know, stems and working on stuff remotely. So it's like, you know, as an artist, you definitely got to keep that in. And then I think it'll help you as your career goes to be able to co-work with people outside of your continent and then create a more universal sound for everybody. So it could definitely be a way to sharpen your sword during this time as a musician, for sure.
Yeah, I look at like some, like I like go to BeatStars a lot and I'm like always shocked. I'm like, wait, that person did that loop, or that Trippie Redd project is like actually based in like Spain, or like, you know, it's like these artists who are going number one on Billboard, they're doing that already. And it's like, you don't have to come with someone with like this let's build energy. It could just be like a mutual respect and see what happens later. But like, this is the time. Like, this has been the time. Like, just go for it.
Facts.
Go for it. Hey, you see, global economy is real, man. Everybody can get touched. Trust me. Send it out. Let's go. I'm ready to hear that. So, all right, am I next, Matt?
Yeah, take us.
Okay, so I got mine is definitely not a party song for one. So let me just put that out. I usually definitely do not do an intro, but it's not as turned up. It's a tribute to the ladies out there. All my ladies. And here we go. It's Matt McGhee, female rappers. Wait, what's the full? Damn, I got running back. What's the full name?
It's called Matt Female McGhee. Rapper Joint.
Female Rapper Joint. Matt McGhee, Female Rapper Joint.
Yeah. Everything starts from now.
I'm showing love, don't it ain't no diss or nothing, don't even think that. Yeah. I let her get the aux cord wherever we go. All she wanna do is get high and listen to Rico. Yeah. My main girl love putting me on the shit like retail chapters of her favorite books, details, food, and female rappers. Any time period, current or if we scale backwards, just peep the TL. Left eye open so you can see well. Nonchalant approach to a lot. It's probably cause I've been in mourning. That's why I can find myself when it's 5 o'clock. We seen too many getting buried. It's hard to tell if niggas friend or foe, some niggas carry. This shit been getting scary. M can see the light been getting dim. I let my guard down around it. Ain't gotta be hardcore, no little Kim. She bring the hard liquor like Bacardi or a little rim. Feel like I'm flying way across the pond to fuck with Lil Sims. I love riding with my girl, she love me to death. I love her too, I'm praying she never make me an ex. A rough rider, even evil bet. My black queen reigns more than another day, that's a Latifah flex. And Ye said a good girl is worth a thousand, but she just wanna blow tree in the car and bump the stallion. And this doja creep up like a cat, it'll scare ya. My chick got mob ties, she get you whacked like Tierra. Stunt at a crazy rate, before Matt, she was crazy straight. My lady great, she been that girl like Baby Tate. Crazy cake like soccer to me, Missy and DeBrat. Give me that Kaya style, I lick the pussy in the crack. I'm tryna make a meal with her like Rockefeller. Listen to her, it ain't all about what I could tell her. I could sell a million dreams, but I'd rather keep it G. Keep it honest, cause I heard that honesty is queen key. Believe me, baby, I can stand the rain. No crime, no misdemeanor. Stiletto still on like Diamond Princess Trina. She never know what she want for certain, she picky. But for now, all she wanna do is get high and listen to Nicki. I let her get the aux cord wherever we go. All she wanna do is play the shit she fucking with. And look to see, I'm loving it, I'm loving her, so fuck it. Gas in the tank. Taking gas by the nugget in the budget. Yeah, something like that. That's all I got. There was way more rappers I wanted to mention, but
yeah, so
that was nice.
So thank you. So I decided to pick this. This is Matt McGhee, DMV. Shout out Social Rail, because she was in the comments ready. And she already was hit.
That was nice.
So I definitely decided to pick that because I got in not a little bit of trouble, but I always put my respect on the rappers who happen to be women, and I feel like this is just one of those good classic rap songs that shouts out people, but it just so happened to be a specific topic, and it was other women rappers, and I was like, damn, that's fire! Like, I don't think anybody has really done that yet, and as a young male rapper. It was just very interesting and nice to see a humble song bigging up other women rappers who, and there's a lot of legends in there. And it was nice to just name drop one by one. And it was a smooth little track. So just simply because of my troubles and and the fact that I do love the rappers who happen to be women.
We do love rappers. Who happen to be women. A lot of rappers killing it these days. To give Melanie, to give you some back, and to give all of our Twitch viewers some background, Rashad has gotten himself in some hot water. Two episodes ago, I think we played a track and Rashad said, we got a lady rapper, blah, blah, blah. And Keish, our friend Keish Herman said, we just call them rappers now. So
yeah, so my bad. Joking.
So we were joking, and I was talking to shout out Brian, shout out Black Grapefruit, who engineers the show, and he goes, I had a dream that Rashad said lady rappers, and I didn't have time to bleep it out on the live stream. And then Rashad sent in this song, and I was like, yo, literally, Rashad has to pick the song, female rappers joint. But that said, shout out to all of those rappers, and I fuck with this song.
Yeah, it wasn't being weird. I feel like I should have shown my homage, my humble appreciation for all the ladies who have contributed as rappers.
As a lady A&R, I appreciate this.
Thank you.
We just call them A&Rs now.
Now y'all just A&Rs.
No, but like the fire thing about this is like, I feel like when this stuff is kind of done, it's always like Queen Latifah, Trina, but like at the same time, it's like, yeah, that's just in the making too. And it's like, you got to look at your peers, and your peers are not only men. So like, by him, like, talk about the young baby Tate's, like, the tear of wax, the Queen Keys, and it's not even, like, in the people in the Rhapsody category. It's, like a multifaceted of the different ways that women can dominate a genre. Like, I appreciate that, because I haven't seen that. And also, vote for young baby Tate in the XXL Freshman, because she can out-sing anybody. But, yeah.
Shameless plug. I love it.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely agree with you. And also, like, to me, these days, some of those women in rap are fucking killer. Like, everybody has to compete with them. They're at the top of the game, you know, putting out some of the best hip hop records out now. And so it's like, that shit is real. And it's fire that, you know, this dude made a song just in tribute to them.
Yeah, yeah. I'm saying, like, he hasn't really put out much work this year. I think this is one of his first tracks that he put out as of 2020. And, you know, again, mentioning that, you know, just acknowledging that there are women rappers who are his peers and are on the come up. And like you said, it's not just about the legends. It's like there's people now that's like breaking records. And I still think Tierra Wack's whole video album, that shit is on the whole. People still got to catch up to that. Nobody really topped that on a visual level yet.
Tierra just put out a quarantine song that's better than what people are going to do all year. Like, it's like, you know, it's one of those kind of like, when I think of artists who built their own world in hip hop, I'm like, okay, besides Tierra, like, I compare her to like people of other genres, because I'm like, who else in hip hop is like, can create their own universe like this with obviously a budget less than like Kendrick or something like that? So I'm just like, it's not even like, oh, these are her peers. I'm just like, who is on her level? Like, you know, like, yeah. Like, I'm waiting for guys to actually like try like as much as she does. Like,
yeah, yeah. And you know, just not to say, and Matt McGhee, I know we did get on a tangent about lady rappers, rappers, but your song is still fire too, bro. Also, but we had to show love, so don't hate because you made the whole song about that, so it's okay. We love you too. Your song is hard, and he does have other, like, you know, nice songs. He has other hits you should probably go check out. But yeah, everybody is I feel like this time now in this music industry, when people are comfortable with making these type of songs, it shows how we have at least opened the door a little bit. It's still a lot more shit that needs to be improved, but we've opened the door to a lot more versatile artists. And I think the general public is acknowledging the fact that, you know, it's not just black males out here rapping, and it's not just, you know, young white women out here making pop music or rock music. So it's a good time. Honestly, we just locked in the house. That's all.
In summation.
Yeah. At the end of the day.
That's a beautiful way to put it, Rashad. It's a good time. We just locked in the house. Well, it is. And that's our live stream. That's 997 live on Twitch. We went through all six of the tracks this evening. I'll give you the little run track list. We started it off Northwest London with Lovely Lonely by Chloe Bodur. And then we had Sensitive by Serena Isioma. We had Home by Knucks, back out in the UK, Top Boy Energy. Then we had Sanford and Sons by Angelo Leroi, Rektless by Mwami, and then Female Rapper Joint by Matt McGhee. Thank you to everybody who tuned in live on Twitter. Thank you, Rashad, for coming through. Thank you, Melanie. Thank you so much. Obviously, I wish this was under different circumstances and we could all be together. Appreciate you hopping on the stream and, you know, testing this out with us.
Yeah. And one last thing, stream Nambi's album Brat out Friday.
Yeah, if you have any plugs, anything else, shout out to all. Shout out to Secretly Group in general.
True.
You know, we want to shout out to Mike.
Big Mike.
Mike's been in the corner the whole time, and We don't have his mic working, so nobody can hear. Mike is the only reason why this is all set up and able to work. So big shout out to Mike and everything that he does for Not 97 and secretly. Shout out to Not 97 and shout out to Harlan from Secretly Group, who also helped us figure out how to do this live stream. Without him, we would be lost. Shout out to Athena at Twitch for just fucking with us and letting us have fun. Back when, whenever we get back to, you know, your regular scheduled programming and we're at NOAA and we're doing Not 97 again, we'll be on Twitch as well and streaming live. So, yeah.
Ho! Ho! Mic drop, motherfuckers! We all Twitch 24/7 now. Let's go.
Take care, everybody.
Much love. Thank you. Peace.